Hey everyone, welcome to the 8th episode of How to Create Your Own First-Person Shooter Single Player Game. In this episode, we are going to turn our player weapon into an automatic weapon and give it a recoil by adjusting this in our gun script. If you want to follow along with the series, check out the card that displays at the top right for the playlist. I would appreciate if you comment down below to let me know what other type of tutorials you would love to see on the channel, as I would like to expand my content more, or even comment what you like in this video, or what I could take into consideration. With Unity open, we want to adjust a gun script, so in your assets folder, go to the scripts folder and expand it and then down to the gun script and double click to open it in Visual Studio. Once open in Visual Studio, we can start with our variables. We are going to need a bool so that we can turn our shooting on and off when we need to. We are also going to need a rate at which our weapon will fire and a time to track when we last fired. So at the top of the ammo variable, we will type private bool is firing equal false and serialize field, because I want to change this in the inspector when I want to, private float fire rate equal 0.1f and private float attack time. Then once we have set up our variables, we can create a new method after our awake method and type private void is shooting. After we have created the method, we can go into our shoot method and cut and paste everything inside the if statement and paste it within our new is shooting method. Now we go down into our shoot method inside of the if statement of get current ammo is greater than zero, and we type is firing equal true. Let us create our update method right after our awake method and then type update, and this will auto generate. And inside our update method, we want to check if we are firing and if we have ammo by typing if is firing and ammo.getCurrentAmmo is greater than zero. Then we want the attack time to increase every time with time that has passed to check if it is time to fire or not. So we will type attack time plus equal time dot delta time. Then we type if attack time is greater or equal than the fire rate, then inside our if statement we type attack time equal 0f to reset the attack time. Then we call the isShooting method and type isShooting. But we now have to stop firing. So after the if statement, we can type else, and then inside the else statement, we type is firing equal false. Now to complete our script, we need to pick up when we leave the mouse input, as the shoot performed makes sure that is firing is set to true, but nothing other than zero ammo makes is firing to false. So go into the awake method and after inputManager.player.shoot.performed, press enter and type inputManager.player.shoot.cancelled plus equal and then press tab to autocomplete and generate the method, and inside the newly created method delete the throw new exception and then type isFiring equal false. Then cut the whole shootCancelled method and paste it underneath the shoot method, just to have all the input methods close to each other. Now we are finished with the code for automatic fire. Let's go back into Unity and test. Once back in Unity, make sure you are in the scene view and maximize on play is turned off, and then press play. Now if you shoot the enemy, the gun should be firing automatically while you hold the shoot button in. Now we know the script works, and now we want to add the recoil function, and to do that we basically want the camera following along the route of the gun to rotate up every time we shoot. And if you click on the player in the hierarchy and expand it and go down to the player capsule and expand it and then click on player camera route and then click on the rotate tool, we can see that this is where the view of the gun is controlled, and we want to manipulate the rotation so that the gun view goes up. We can go ahead and formulate this in our gun script now. So head back into the gun script and right at the top where the variables are after private float attack time. And because we know we are working with the player camera route, I'm going to make it easy on myself and make camera route my variable and serialize it so we can reference it inside of Unity. So we will type serialize field private transform camera root, and then type private float recoil speed equal minus 2f, so that it rotates in the negative direction, which is up by 2 units. Then go down to the bottom of the script, and right after the shoot cancelled method, we can create another method and call it recoil by typing private void recoil. We will use the rotate method on the camera root transform variable and use recoil speed to change the x rotation in the transform. For this, we type camera root.rotate and pass in recoil speed for the x rotation and 0 for the y and 0 for the z. After we have set up our recoil method, we can call the recoil method within the eShooting method. So go up to the eShooting method, and inside the method of the Cine Machine Shake Camera, press Enter and type recoil. Now that we have adjusted our script, we can save and go back into Unity. Once in Unity, in the hierarchy, expand player, then go down and expand main camera so that you see rifle 00. Then go down and expand player capsule so that you can see player camera root. Now click on rifle and drag player camera root into the camera root box in the gun script in the inspector window. That was the last step. So now we can play and test. So make sure you are in scene view and maximize on play is turned off, and then press play to test. Hold in the shoot button and you should be experiencing automatic fire, and the gun should have a recoil effect, as you should be able to see the gun go up when you shoot. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, join the Discord channel if you want to learn more about game development, and if you would just like to join the community or ask for any advice. Check out all the links down below for all of the information. Source code is also down below, as well as the full Git project. Remember about the comment down below with what you would like to see next. Keep well and see you in the next episode. Cheers.